I implore you, as a fan of football, to tell me that whether or not you cheer for the Patriots or the Buccaneers or Michigan or whoever Tom Brady has touched in his football life, that you are not at all fascinated, if not cheer this person on, sometimes even a twin. She's kind of elevated above like being hated anymore, I think. I think people are just fascinated that he is 45 years old operating at this clip. I get sick to my stomach when I could even fathom that any of us even whispered on this show into existence, like, oh, he's done. Oh, he can't do it anymore, because the roller coaster that is Tom Brady, it is just buckle up and hang on. Because Tom Brady, this is like when he got drafted, right? It's just like Mr. Irrelevant, he doubted, like he barely had half starts at Michigan. Then he comes in and he's like, you want to watch what I can do? This is what I can do. I will turn your stomach upside down on this roller coaster faster. He does it to us in the offseason. He retires, he even retires. He goes 3-6, and now what is he gonna do? Be like the third best team in the NFC? I cannot fathom, and it's silly of all of us fools to think that Tom Brady wouldn't do anything besides give us a great storyline.
It's a great
season.
One. November and December. This is his time.
So Tom, you've won in Germany, you've won in England, you've won in Mexico, you've won in the United States.
Where's next?
What's next? Czechoslovakia?
This was a first today for the NFL and for you in Germany. Describe what this was like.
It was a great atmosphere.
We really didn't get close to Tom tonight. You know, we had a whole rush plan and a concept that we were going with, and we couldn't get to him. And so he had his second opportunities to find his receivers, and he did a great job of it. I thought he played really, really well tonight.
The game was all Tampa Bay. Buccaneers found a way to win. Tom Brady looking like vintage Tom Brady. Buccaneers defense plays the best game they've played all season.
Big guys up front played great. Receivers played great. Everyone made plays. We ran the ball great, so that's what we need to do.
They played a really good football game. Tampa Bay did what they wanted to do, and particularly early in the game, they were able to keep us off balance, and we have not been like that for a while, and so we had to regroup.
Their defense is better than what you think. They're ninth in total defense, fifth in pass defense.
You almost caught a touchdown. What happened on that one?
I slipped.
Had he not slipped, you would have seen his 42-inch vertical. Unfortunately, that corner is a former college receiver who jumps a lot higher than me. And it's much more athletic. I was hoping to be wide open, and I probably was on the first one. And I think they were pretty clued in on the second one. They said, cover him, and I was on the sideline, and I tried to yell, Lenny, no, but it was too late.
The three long scoring drives, your three longest in terms of time this year,
wow.
All over 85 yards.
Wow. Give them credit. You know, they mixed it well. I think the way that they mixed their play passes with Tom, you know, as they've always done, it's nothing new, as we've seen it a million times, and that was really effective.
Get open, Tom, and throw you the football. Yeah. All you got to do, your job is easy. Get open and catch.
My number was called early. Tried to make a play. I was wide open, so I was just like, I got to score. I got to do something with it.
What was the difference today versus early this season?
Well, I thought we ran the ball well, and some play action passes worked off of that. So when you run it well, you know, you don't have to be in drop back protections all day and puts too much stress on the passing game. I mean, you don't want to be one-dimensional, and we've been one-dimensional too many times this year. So the fact that we didn't have as many pass attempts, I love. You know, the fact that we ran some play action, I love. Guys made plenty of big plays in the pass game, and I still think we had more out there to get to.
But most importantly, we were here to try to play and win a football game, which, you know, I thought we did a lot of great things out there. So it wasn't perfect, but I think the best part is winning the game and feeling like we made some improvements. And we have a bye week now, so we can take a little bit of time to refresh and get ready to, you know, make a big push and figure out kind of some of the things we haven't done well the first 10 weeks of the year and see how we can get better.
They just snapped a three-game losing streak, 16-13 against the Rams.
We got up against a team that played really well against us, and we weren't able to overcome it.
Like I said, it's amazing, man. Like I said, everybody's contributing. We're moving the ball around a lot. We're running the ball, throwing the ball to different receivers, tight ends, running backs. And for me to be wide open like that, like I said, I had to score.
He is a guy that is willing to sacrifice anything to continue to help his team build and to continue to get better.
They threw and caught it in spectacular fashion. The guys making the plays, they got great receivers, and they showed it tonight. They came through with guys hanging all over them and with some terrific throws, and they kept converting, and that was the difference in the game.
Tom Brady has played three overseas games. He's averaging a little over 300 yards passing and three touchdowns in those contests, and he hadn't lost.
Shame on all 31 of these teams if Brady can somehow still be standing here. Mm-hmm. Shame on you for not putting that cockroach down when you had the chance. He's still, he right now is a boxer, just like up against the ropes, but like he's not knocked out yet, and you had your chance. You had your chance. And the league, of all the seasons for the NFC to be putrid, this is the one? Brady is 3-5 at one point. The Rams, they fall apart. The Packers, this could have been their moment. They fall apart. You go team by team by team. Right now, the Eagles and the Vikings are the only teams in the NFC with one loss or less. And I have no confidence if Brady's in a playoff game against Jalen Hurts or Kirk Cousins that Brady's going to get the best of them.
Right?
This was the moment, this first 2 months of the season, to put Brady down and out, and you couldn't do it. Mm-hmm. You gave him a little window. You gave him a slight window. If the Rams win that game, which they very easily could have on Sunday in Tampa, Brady right now is 2-3-6.
Yep.
Bucks are looking up. They're like, this is going to be tough. Right now, the Buccaneers have momentum. The Buccaneers have confidence. And God forbid they win this weekend against the Seahawks. And they fly back. And they're looking at the NFC South. And they're looking at P.J. Walker and Marcus Mariota throwing the ball like this last night from his back. And we're looking at a Saints team that has been awful. You let Brady back in the room. You let him hang around. And gosh, shame on you, 31 other teams.
Yeah, they were better. I think there's still room for improvement, obviously. You know, the two, we had a chance in the first drive, got a holding penalty, and then ended up not getting the field goal. And then we had the interception, two interceptions. So one with Lenny and one with me. So cut down our turnovers, be a little better on third down, a little better in red area. Certainly if we run the ball better, I think we give ourselves a great chance to win going forward. So it makes it a lot easier for all of us when the run game does what it's doing and did what it did today. And just really proud of everyone really coming together, understanding how important that was for us, and figuring out a way to get a win.
I believe this team has the capability of catching fire as it gets a little healthier down the stretch.
They know where the fault lies. They understand that there are things that need to be corrected. And he said the biggest thing that this team is leaning on is that they feel like the issues they have are fixable. They feel like they're correctable. I thought the other thing that was interesting to note from Byron's presser before he left is he was asked about that hug. And I know we talked about it on this show, him and Brady at the end when Brady scored that touchdown with 9 seconds to go. And you saw so much emotion. He was asked about that. And he said, look, we are not going to apologize for winning 16-13. No matter how we have to win, a win is a win.
Chris made a heck of a catch coming down. Rashad made a heck of a run. I had, a catch as well. But we just moved the ball. Sneak did a great job to really kind of get it going. But like I said, it's just everybody just playing their part. Nobody's getting riled up or anything like that. When the play comes, we just make it.
Nobody's been more committed to their sport than Tom Brady in the history of athletics.
It was great to go into the bye week with a win. Obviously, two wins, so hopefully we're trending forward. You almost don't want to have a bye since you want two in a row, but we got some guys nicked up. We need to get healthy, so we'll get some rest and we'll get ready for the stretch run.
Tampa Bay's feeling really good as they fly back to the USA tonight.
Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe as I post a new Tom Brady video every day.